Hello students, well today we are going to study about Chinese food, one of the most important topic in the 6th semester. You can refer previous year question papers, you will find 2 to 3 questions will always come from this topic in the exam. So let's start, we'll talk about the silent features of this cuisine now. Well, China officially the People's Republic of China is a country in East Asia and is the world's most populous country with a population of around 428 billion in 2017. China's climate is mainly dominated by dry seasons and wet monsoon, which lead to pronounced temperature difference between winter and summer. It includes styles originating from the diverse region of China. The history of Chinese cuisine is around 1000 years old. It has changed from period to period and each region it depends upon the climate and other local preference. Chinese cuisine is one of the three grand cuisine in the world. The staple food of Chinese cooking are rice and noodles. Famines and adversity force the Chinese people to utilize strange plants and roots in their food. Food is simple yet artistic and skillful, like the French cuisine. Menus are a balance of carbohydrate and meat. So the other silent features of this food is that soy sauce, peanut oil, sherry, vinegar, ajinomoto, corn flour, bean sprout and ham are some common ingredients that are used. And Chinese cuisine always have a staple fan which represents cereals, like as I said, rice, noodles, wheat also is part of the fan. Then bite-sized foods are eaten with chopstick. Cooking temperature is high or civil. Then the cereals are generally accompanied by kai, referring to meat and vegetable dishes, which adds flavor and variety. Then there are different types of vegetables and non-vegetarian food that is enjoyed by the people, for which they adopt different cooking methods. Generally, the Chinese food is steamed, stir-fried, stewed, baked, roasted, and they enjoy different types of cooking method, which we'll be covering later in this video, the different cooking techniques and method which is generally used. Throughout China, pork is actually most widespread, except in West China, because there are Muslim, those who are there in this region. That is why these people, they don't eat pork. Seasoning in China's cooking are numerous to count. They use different types of seasonings and flavorings, which you can see on the screen also. Then when we talk about the beverages, Chinese people are very fond of tea. They enjoy different types of tea. Different flavors teas are available in China. These teas range in flavor from sweet to bitter, earthy to smoky. And the Chinese people generally prefer green tea. And the most favored tea of Chinese people is Dragon Well tea from Hangzhou province. This tea is actually one of the most popular tea in China. Then, along with the tea, alcoholic drink is also part of their tradition. Chinese women generally they avoid alcoholic drinks. Alcohols is generally consumed by males, and the wine in China is made from fermented rice and other grains, and they have got different alcoholic strength. Chinese people generally they don't drink wine too much, although they have got vineyards in China, and their wines are actually same like of Western countries. And many Chinese rice wine, such as wine from Shaoxing in Southeast China, have a nutty sherry like quality. Then coming on to the other characteristic, that when coming on to the desserts, Chinese people actually they are not that much fond of having desserts. They generally end their meal with fresh fruits and vegetables. Although different types of cakes, cookies and desserts are available, and their desserts are very less sugary as compared to the Western desserts. Their pastries are made from rice flour, and for that they use different types of filling. Then one of the most important festival in China is Moon Festival. एंड ड्यूरिंग दिस फेस्टिवल दे मेक मून केक विच इज एक्चुअली राउंड पेस्ट्रीज विच आर फिल्ड विद डिफरेंट स्वीट फीलिंग एंड जनरली दिस मून केक्स आर यूज टू गिव एज गिफ्ट्स बिकॉज एज आई सेड चाइनीज पीपल दे एंड देयर मील विद डेजर्ट्स सो दे आर नॉट फॉन्ड ऑफ दैट मच डेजर्ट्स नाउ वील टॉक अबाउट द फूड ऑफ नॉर्थ वेल Northern China experiences harsh cold and dry winters as well as hot summer, which makes calories and salt replacement more important. A strong flavor is very important for Northern Chinese people who achieve with the salt and strong seasoning. Then the most popular seasoning used in this region are soy sauce, vinegar, garlic, ginger, leek, star anise seed, sweet bean sauce, chili pepper and sesame oil. Northern Chinese chefs make use of seasoning to add richness to dishes without covering up the natural flavor of the ingredients. Then most of the northern cuisine ingredients are based on the region agriculture product which are limited due to the cold and dry weather in the north. They eat different types of cereals which is actually the important part of their meal. Wheat is the staple crop of northern China and wheat flour products in the form of noodles, dumplings, steamed buns, stuffed buns and pancakes are available. Rice is also eaten in the north but is definitely secondary to wheat. Dumplings are very popular in the north which is served with vinegar and hot chili oil for dipping. There are various meat and vegetable fillings. For breakfast, there are steamed buns, stuffed buns, then hand-pulled noodles and sliced noodles are also very common dishes in north which is either stir fried or eaten in the form of soup. Well, Beijing is actually the national capital of the China and in Beijing there are different types of delicacies which are prepared and it is part of their tradition. The Beijing food is based on the imperial cuisine which is around 1000 years old. Bear's paw, camel hump and bird's nest are some of the exotic dishes that are enjoyed by people and this they have got from the tradition. Today Beijing cuisine is called Lao Beijing and one of the famous dish of Beijing is Peking duck and this meat is characterized by its thin crisp skin with authentic version of the dish serving mostly the skin and little meat sliced in the front of the diners by the cook. Duck are bred specially for the dish, are slaughtered after 65 days and seasoned before being roasted in a closed or hung oven. The meat is often eaten with spring onion, cucumber and sweet bean sauce with pancakes rolled around the filling. Sometimes pickled radish is also inside and other sauces like hoisin can be used. Then they have another famous chicken which is called beggar's chicken, which is generally wrapped in lotus leaf and then it is baked in clay oven in hot ashes for hours. This is the famous dish of this region. Then they have steaming Mongolian hot pots and barbecues that you can find everywhere in northern China. So this is actually the integral part of the Chinese food. Then some of the famous dessert of these regions are toffee bananas and apples are also a specialty. These desserts are not that much sweet. Chinese people, they don't like sweet taste that much. Then onion cakes and spring onion pancakes are also famous from this region as both of them are originated here. Now we'll talk about the Eastern China food. It is the food of Yangtze Delta area, Shanghai, Yangzhou, Suzhou, Nanjing, Yellow Mountains. Eastern China food mainly features a sweet and subtle flavor. They use sugar, wine, vinegar and soy sauce. So Eastern food features an abundant use of seafood, fish, pork, poultry and vegetable. The river delta is actually a fertile region with rich farming land nourished by subtropical climate which allow for production of wide variety of vegetable. Both rice and wheat are common staple of this region. The large number of lakes and river tributaries provide abundant fish and shellfish to the region. It has a abundant seafood because it is situated near to the coastal region. Pork and chicken are used as well in this region. Well, Jingyasu cuisine is very important cuisine of this region. Jingyasu cuisine features extensive ingredients that mainly come from rivers, lakes and the sea. Various cooking techniques and executive cutting techniques are used. It commonly used stewing, braising, simmering and warming to preserve the original flavor and maintain clarity, freshness and mildness. Some of the important cuisine from this region are based on the seafood, because as I said, it is situated near to the coastal region, so they enjoyed different types of food. Then Jezang cuisine is also the famous cuisine of this region, and the characteristic of this cuisine depends upon the careful selection of the ingredients and elaborate preparation, and each style is noted for its special flavor and taste, and they have got their own specialization in ingredients. And red cooking is favored method of cooking. These area people, they enjoy different types of snacks, and some of the specialties of this region are spare ribs, which is cooked in soy sauce and rice wine. Then lion's head meatballs is also famous from this region. Now we'll talk about the western cuisine of the China. Western China is actually mainly Xinjiang province and Tibet. The food reflects the characteristic of the culture, geography, climate and agriculture of this region. The region of Xinjiang in northwest China is traditionally home to ethnic Muslim people. So there is no pork or carnivorous animals on the menu. Being a region with lots of pasture, sheep feature on top of the menu. And this region is also famous for its fruit, particularly dry fruits, which can be seen in their cuisine. And it is mostly composed of deserts and mountains, so land is limited. Wheat is the main staple grain and few vegetables are grown here. Mostly onions, carrot, peppers, eggplants and tomatoes are available in abundance. Then this cuisine features mutton top of its ingredient list. Other protein food includes beef, camel meat, horse meat and various dairy products. It is actually a multi-ethnic area, so the diet of this region varies from ethnic custom, beliefs and ways of life. There is Uyghur cuisine mainly, but also Han, Kazakh. The common cooking method includes stir frying, roasting and steaming. They used one chili flavor as their important ingredients, and cooking style are also unusual. The fish flavored sauce are made from one cuisine. All of you know they have got one pepper which gives hotness to their food. This pepper is very famous from this region, and that is why the Sichuan food is very hot and spicy, because they use this pepper in their food. Then ham. This ham has a thin skin, thick meat, a bright color and a strong aroma. Then they have got Yunnan steam pot chicken. So it is prepared in unique way. Then the famous dish of this region is crossing the bridge noodles. It is actually a rice noodles. It is a type of snack which is prepared with high quality rice. Thin, long and soft rice noodles are especially delicious. Crossing the bridge rice noodles are meticulously prepared with broth, sliced meat and seasoning. Now we'll talk about the food of the south. Well, the food of south is widely regarded as the country best south Chinese cuisine. It centers on Canton and Hong Kong region. So the southern food of the China is actually sar. So that is why you will find some of the soup from this region, like hot and sour soup. So this cuisine incorporates ingredients from all over the China, and it is known for its sometimes use of exotic animals. These region people, they enjoy different types of non-veg food, which is actually part of their meal. The cooking emphasizes absolute freshness of ingredients and correct technique. Ingredients are usually prepared with a light touch, just enough cooking and seasoning to bring out the natural flavor of the food. A wide range of cooking techniques are used, but steaming and stir-frying are especially common cooking methods from this region. Then, the cuisine is famous for its seafood, especially steamed fish and shellfish prepared in various ways. So, there are different types of seafood dishes which are available from this region. Pork and duck are glazed with mixture of sugar, wine and soy and roasted to a beautiful golden red, which you can see on the picture also. So the dishes are served with rice. It is as the rice is available in abundance in this region because they have got fertile soil, and this region is also famous for its dim sums. There are varieties of flavor and filling that are used to stuff this type of dim sum. The most particular thing about Hakka food is the cooking techniques. Like they use pressure cooking, quick frying, stewing and sauces they use. Hakka foods is very vinegary and salty, and they use large number of pickled vegetables. Then the Hakka people also like different types of food. Now we'll talk about some of the ingredients like wood ears, then shiitake type of mushroom, then they used dry chilies also, dried shrimp. Chinese people eat lots of type of food, seaweed, tangerine peel also you can find in their food, then red dates, which is actually very famous in Western China, then lotus leaf, lotus root and lotus seeds. So lotus leaf is also used to wrap different chicken items, which is generally baked in some part of China. Then noodles, as I said, is integral part of the Chinese cuisine. So different varieties of noodles are available, as you can see in the picture, wheat noodle, egg noodle. Then rice, cereals is again important part of the China food. There are different types of rice that are available, spring roll wrappers, long grain rice, then baby corn, bamboo shoot, peppers, then bean sprout, mangy trout. All these are also used for making different types of noodles and soup. You can find baby corn soup, then spinach, spring onion, Chinese turnip, bok choy, Chinese cabbage. So Chinese food mainly depends upon their cutting style, the way they cut the vegetables. Then lotus root, water chestnut, lychees, kumquat, all these are dry fruits which again found in abundance in the Western China. And Western Chinese people, they use lots of dry fruits in their cooking. Dry ginger, five spice powder, star anise seed powder, szechuan pepper, onion, peppercorn, curry powder. Szechuan pepper, which gives hotness to the food. Then they use different types of oil and vinegar also, like chili oil, sesame oil, rice wine is also used, rice vinegar is also used, especially in the west southern China where the food is hot and sour. They use different types of paste like chili bean paste, black bean paste. So the black bean paste is generally made from fermented black beans, and chili paste is prepared from soya bean. Then Chinese mustard, shrimp paste, this is made from pungent pulverized dried shrimp. Then Chinese mustard is actually used in China for making different types of dishes. Then this is one of the most important sauce, hoisin sauce. It's a sweet and garlicky salted yellow soya bean sauce, often used as a dipping sauce. Then hot garlic sauce, yellow bean sauce, oyster sauce. So this Cantonese dipping sauce, it is available both in sweet and salt version, made from oyster. Then the plum sauce, made from plum, which is generally sweet in taste. Now red sweet bean paste and soy sauce, which is used for making different types of noodles, chowmein, etc. So now we'll talk about the different types of equipments that are used in Chinese cuisine. So all of you must have read about wok. Chinese people use wok for making all their dishes, be it soup or non-veg, noodles, chowmein, you name it, and for that they require this wok. Along with wok, there is one brush also, which is used generally for cleaning after each preparation. Then the bamboo steamer, this is used for steaming different types of food. Then cleaver, this is called Chinese knife, which can cut through the bones. So these are actually stainless steel cleavers that are generally used by Chinese people. Then they have flat wire strainer, so these are used and generally useful when we are deep frying any food item. Then the sizzling platter dishes, also called iron plate dishes, have recently become popular menu items in Chinese restaurant. Not only in Chinese, but you can find them across the world now. Sizzling chicken and sizzling other dishes have become very famous, not only in China but around the world. Then clay pot dishes are also very common in this region, for which they use different types of pot, which you can see on the screen also. Different types of cooking methods are used by Chinese people. For that they have got different vessels and utensils, and clay pot is one of them. Then they have Mongolian hot pot. It is a copper stove with a chimney in the center in which charcoal is put. The lighted charcoal keeps the stock around it at a steady simmer, and pieces of sliced meat and vegetables are cooked just by plunging them shortly in the stock. So very traditional Chinese equipment. Now we'll talk about different types of cooking methods. One is chuan, that means quick or rapid boiling. Then shu, instant boiling or rinsing. AQ, stewing or braising. Hui, braising. Yan means pickling. Jian, shallow frying. Ta, pan frying. Ja, deep frying. Liu, saute. Then we have penj, quick braising. Dun, slow cooking. Men, slow braising. Ju, boiling. Zheng, steaming. Kao, roasting. Shun, smoking. Chao, stir frying. Jiang, soya braising. So these are some of the cooking methods which are generally used for making different types of Chinese food. Now we'll talk about snacks and starters. Well, spring rolls, all of you must be familiar with them. They are very famous in India also. So different types of filling are used for them, which is rolled and then can be deep fried. Then steam glutinous rice in lotus leaf. Chinese people, they use rice and lotus leaf for making this food. Generally they are steamed. Then spicy salt and pepper spare ribs, they are marinated with different ingredients, and then they are sprinkled with chili flakes, and spring onions are also used. They are deep fried in the oil. Spring onion pancake, they are made from hot water dough and then sprinkled with spring onion greens. So these pancakes are part of the cereal menu. Then braised chicken wings, these are marinated with soya sauce and hoisin sauce and then braised till the wings get a sticky coating. So Chinese people, they enjoy turnip cake also. So this grated turnip is mixed with shrimp, mushroom, sausage, seasoning and rice flour, and then they are steamed. Before the service, they are cut into squares and then they are deep fried and generally served with soya or chili sauce, which is generally used as a dipping. Then tea eggs, these are hard boiled eggs which are braised in tea and soya mixture. That is why they get the different color. Pickled cucumber or cabbage, these are actually salt, ginger and red chili are applied to the cabbage. and then they are cooked in a wok. They are stir fried in wok, and then different vinegar and sauce is used. Then Cantonese corn soup. It is actually a thick soup made from corn, and egg white threads are also used for garnishing purpose. Generally, different types of versions are available, can be plain or can be made with chicken also. Then we have shark fin soup, shark fin and chicken, which is cooked in stock and then flavored with soy sauce and vinegar. Then we have tomato egg drop soup. So this tomato flavored stock in which we use egg white threads. So egg white is poured at the last, and then the egg white is whisked inside the soup to get these threads. Then bean curd and spinach soup, as you can see on the screen. See, in most of the Chinese cuisine, they use different types of stock. Chicken stock is the most preferred one, and in the stock they use different food items which make different varieties of soup. Then sliced fish and coriander soup again. So seasoned stock with fish and coriander leaves, and it is actually a clear soup. Then we have hot and sour soup, very famous soup made from chicken, seafood along with bamboo shoots, mushroom, bean curd, then shredded greens, and egg white threads are also used at the last. In most of the Chinese soup you will find egg white threads. Then they have clear vegetable soup also, made with stock, bamboo shoots, carrot, baby corn, mushroom, shredded greens, vegetables, and tomato quarters are also used for garnish. Then Cantonese style steamed fish. These are marinated fish, and then they are steamed and served along with spring onion, ginger, and pepper, as you can see on the screen. Then deep fried squid flowers with spicy salt. This blanched squid, which is marinated in ginger, wine, and different types of vegetables are used. And five spice powder is also used for making this dish. Sweet and sour prawns with vegetables. The prawns are marinated with rice, wine, ginger, oil, corn flour, and they are tossed in a wok. And then they are served with the help of soy sauce. Then different ingredients are also used, which you can see on the screen also. Actually, the video will become very lengthy, so I am not able to describe each and everything in detail, but you can go through the screen. Everything has been described properly. Then we have lovebird prawns. Here half of the prawns are fried, and then half of the prawns are cooked in other style, then they are mixed together at last. Then salt and pepper soft shelled crabs. These are marinated soft shelled crabs which are coated with egg and dusted with flour, and then fried till golden in color. Then scallops with black bean sauce. Stir fried scallops with sauce of black bean, soya, and oyster sauce. Spring onion, ginger, and garlic are also used for garnishing purpose, and generally they are accompanied with these vegetables. The lobster furong. Furong means egg white, and it denotes a classic Cantonese cooking method. Lobster meat are topped with rice, wine, vinegar, and salt are coated with a batter of beaten egg whites and cream of tartar. The meat is then fried till fluffy. The chicken stock, rice, wine, and salt, white pepper, and other are combined and cooked with onion and ginger. The cooked lobster is added at last, then it is tossed and then served. Then we have crispy fried squid. These are similar to fried calamari. So the squid are actually dipped into the batter, and then they are deep fried and generally served with the help of the sauce. Then Yunnan pot chicken is cooked in this earthenware. So this dish is served along with this pot. So the dish is served directly from this pot. So different types of ingredients are used along with chicken. Kung Pao chicken, very famous chicken. Stir fried chicken with water chestnut and cashew nuts in chili and soya flavored sauce with spring onion, ginger, chili, and garlic. Then they have red cooked chicken. Here the whole chicken is marinated in vinegar, different types of spices like star anise, fennel, soy sauce, vinegar, etc. are used. After it is cooked and brushed with sesame oil and then served with liquid that is left after the cooking. Then drunken chicken, it is served with the help of drunken sauce, which is generally poured at last from the top. The drunken sauce consists of rice wine and other ingredients. Then we have spicy crispy pork. Then five spice flavored roast pork served with dipping sauce of soya and chilies. So all these beef and peppers and black bean sauce, fried marinated strip of beef and pepper tossed in black bean sauce and flavored with ginger, soya, sesame, oil and rice wine. All these are prepared in wok. Then stir fried beef with spring onions. The beef are roast stir fried first and then they are made in the wok with the help of spring onion. Stir fried lamb with leeks, marinated sliced lamb cooked with dried mushroom and leeks in a yellow bean sauce. Then we have braised bean curd with Chinese mushroom. Strips of bean curd and dried black mushrooms are cooked with soya sauce. Rice wine, sesame oil, sugar and corn flour is also used for making this dish. Then bean curd with chili and spring onion. So diced bean curd with spring onion, chili, coriander, soya sauce scattered over it. It is topped with hot sesame and vegetable oil. So all these are very famous dish. Stir fried bean curd in yellow bean sauce. So actually this dish is repeating again. So we'll come on to the next dish now. Buddha's Delight. Stir fried tiger lily buds, Chinese mushroom, black mushroom, bean curd, sprouts, carrot and other vegetables are used for flavoring purpose and then they are generally cooked in the vegetable stock. Stir fried Chinese cabbage. The cabbage is shredded and then stir fried along with vinegar, soy sauce and other ingredients in the wok. Then we have double cooked beans. These fried green beans with finely chopped onion, mustard, cabbage, soya sauce and rice wine is also used to flavor these beans. Then we have Sichuan spicy style aubergines. So steamed pieces of aubergines are tossed with the dressing of soy sauce and other ingredients. Finely chopped spring onion, garlic and chili bean paste is also used for making this dish. Then we have stir fried bok choy. So bok choy is stirred fried with garlic, ginger, sugar, soy sauce in little stock in the wok. Then we'll come on to the rice and egg fried rice. Chinese people, they enjoy different types of cereals. So rice is also an integral part of their food along with the noodles. So you can see they make noodles with the help of different vegetables. The noodles are generally colorful. And in most of the noodles, they use soy sauce, chili vinegar, normal vinegar. And these noodles are cooked very fast in the wok. Most of these noodles are stir-fried. So noodles, as I said, is the integral part of the Chinese cuisine. That is why in China, you can find different types of noodles made from different flours. The menu is incomplete without noodles. So one of the famous noodle is mian, made from wheat and barley, and they are generally made by machine, can be handmade also. Then fen is actually another flour that is used for making these noodles. Flour of millets and rice is also used. It is also made with the help of fancy, that is mung bean flour. Then gansi is made from pressed bean curd. So different types of noodles are available. Like many areas of China have noodle dish associated with it. In Beijing there are lo mein, the pool noodles that are also known as dragon whiskers. In Sichuan you have crossing the bridge, chow mein. and chopsi. So what is the difference between chow mein and chopsi? Well, chow mein is actually boiled in water. These noodles are boiled in water and then they are stir fried in wok with the help of other vegetables and then can be served directly. Then chopsi are actually fried in oil and then they are served with sauce along with the vegetables. So the steamed chow mein and American Chinese chow mein. American chow mein are actually deep fried, while this in American they call it chopsi, in China they call it chow mein. That is the main difference. In Canadian Chinese restaurant, they offer different types of chow mein, which is not similar to America. So in each country, you will find different types of cooking methods which are used for making Chinese these noodles. In India also, we use different flavors and soy sauce. Each country have their own different methods. So plain chow mein is similar to Western chow mein, but contains more mung bean sprouts. Some recipes may be up to 1.5 bean sprout. So in China, they eat lots of sprouted beans also, which they used for making chow mein. In India, in other countries, you will not find sprouted beans or other dry or sprouted dal. Like chopsi is actually American Chinese dish, as I said earlier also, cooked quickly with vegetables such as bean sprouts, cabbage, celery. And it is typically served with rice, but can become the Chinese American food. In some chopsi, you will find they are deep fried also. We have ginger pudding, little bowls of ginger, flavored sweetened milk that is set, served warm. Then fried fragrant bananas, batter fried bananas, drizzled with honey, tossed in wok with caramel, honey and sesame seed. See, most of the Chinese desserts are less sweety. Darsan, deep fried flat noodles tossed with honey and sesame. So now we'll talk about this Peking duck. Well, Peking duck, as already I told you earlier, is a dish from Beijing that has been prepared since the imperial era. The meat is characterized by its thin crisp skin, with authentic version of the dish serving mostly the skin and little meat, sliced in front of the diners by the cook. Ducks are bred specially for the dish, are slaughtered after 65 days and seasoned before being roasted in a closed or hung oven. The meat is often eaten with spring onion, cucumber and sweet bean sauce, with pancakes rolled around the filling. Sometimes pickled radish is also inside, and other sauces like hoisin sauce is also used for making this dish. So this is one of the famous dishes from Beijing, and it is the dish has got a history of 1,000 years, and this cuisine has been derived from the imperial cuisine of China. And the duck has been roasted in China since the southern and northern dynasties. That is why a variation of roast duck was prepared for the emperor of China in Yuan dynasty. So this dish was originally named Shao Yaji, and it has been mentioned in various cookbooks in China, and generally it is cooked inside the oven. By the mid 20th century, Peking duck had become a national symbol of China, favored by tourists and diplomats alike. So different diplomats and other people, embassies people, those who come to the China, they always have this dish. That is why it is the national symbol of China now, and that is why it is the most important part of the Beijing cuisine. So I have tried to cover the Chinese food with the maximum which I was able to. But beside these dishes, there are many other dishes which are very famous in China, because China is a very vast country and it is not possible to cover each and everything with the help of video. But I have tried to cover all the important dishes of this region. And with this, I finish the video, and I hope this video will be useful to you. And you can go through the slides, you can go through the notes which I have mentioned in the slides. That will be very useful to you. I will come again with another video. Till the time, take care. Bye bye.